Today we're going to look at the R-828 and how to use it as a radio direction finder. Unlike non-directional beacons, in order for this radio to function, you will need to set up a unit transmitting inside the mission. Frequently you're going to find these used on airbases and FOBs, and maybe if you're doing a search and rescue mission, so we'll jump over to the editor. So in this quick scenario I've got my helicopter, and we've got a simple FARP set up here. I'm going to click on the ATC truck, and we're going to set them up to transmit by adding an action, and we're going to pick out set frequency. And then we're going to pick a frequency between 20 and 59.9 megahertz, which is the limits of our radio set, so I'm going to go with 50. We also need to make sure it's set to AM, and we can set the power. This can be whatever you want, the bigger the number, the longer range it will be. I'm just going to stick it at 30, but it shouldn't matter too much. Now we need to add another command, and this will be to transmit a message. And I'm going to set an audio. You have to pick a file for this, otherwise it just won't run. So select file, and I'm going to use a WAV file I've created. This is the Morse code for red. So we'll hear that transmitted when we're tuned in. So I'm going to press OK, and I'm going to tell the signal to loop. So now it will keep on repeating the signal on the frequency of 50 MHz AM. With a 30 watt signal strength. With that set, we now need to set up our radio on our aircraft. So we're going to jump over to our helicopter, and we're going to pick the radio channels button. From here we can see the radio presets for our radios. We want the R-828, and you can see we have 10 presets, channel 0 through 9. So I'm going to set channel 1 to be 50 MHz, which is the same as the channel we put on our ATC vehicle. And now when we set channel 1, we'll be able to tune in and find the direction to it. So let's jump over to the helicopter. Okay, so in the cockpit, we need to find our radio, and it's located down on the far right, so it may help if you hide the seat by pressing backspace, and we can see the radios here, so let's close up on that. So what we need to do is set the channel that we wish to use, so I'm going to rotate that over to channel 1, and now we press the auto button to tune our radio to that frequency. Once it's done, this light will flicker on and then off. So we'll press and hold. And now we're tuned. We can turn the squelch on and off if we want to remove the noise, and we can control the volume. Now we've set this radio up, it's listening to the frequency, we now want to use it to be our radio direction finder, so we're going to go down to this panel here where it says ADF VHF2, and we're going to set the P828, which is this radio box here, to the compass position. Next we need to enable the ARK-U2, which is the direction finding kit, and turn that on. So now everything is set up. So if we jump back over to our heading indicator on the instrument panel, over on our heading indicator you can see we've got the arrow and the course line, and none of these are pointing at our radio just yet. We've got here the mode switch for ZK and ARK-U2. So currently we're in the set position. The set position, it means this needle is governed by the set course knob. If we switch it over to the ARK-U2 position, however, we can now see the course is pointing towards the radio beacon. If we want to go back to using a course, we simply flip the knob back to set position. So we'll simply leave the heading indicator in the ARK-U2 mode and follow the needles. Just like the non-directional beacon, the radio direction finder only gives us a bearing on our course and nothing else, so we can't tell the range. So we have to guess where it is, and we can estimate that a bit by watching how fast the needle's moving. If it's moving fast, it means we're passing by it, and that means we're reasonably close. If it's moving slowly and rotating around, that means we are of course moving past it, but at a distance. So we can see here on the gauge, it's off to our right about 20 degrees, and we know it's out there somewhere in that forest, so we're going to turn toward it. So we make our way round. Now remember, we are following the course needle this time round, and just like before, it can be a bit unstable during manoeuvres. So now we can start searching for our forward operating base, which should be in one of these clearings up ahead. And so you can see, we followed our course line and we found the FARP. And of course that needle is pointing directly at that vehicle out there, the ATC vehicle. So that's all there is to the ADF finder. You'll typically find these used in missions as a marker for a base, just like this, or maybe occasionally as a navigation aid, or to help you find someone who's in distress. They do not occur naturally inside the game and do need to be set up, and you do need to have the presets set up in the editor beforehand in order to use them, because they cannot be transmitted, cannot be tuned to, manually. Information on what presets are available and used for the mission will typically be found in the briefing information, and on your kneeboard. If you want to practice this, there's an instant action mission which is set up exactly for this. We can jump in and check it out, and you'll find the frequencies in the briefing images much like you would on any typical mission. I hope you enjoyed, and take care.